Let's talk about ecocide. The planet is dying. Rising temperatures, melting ice caps, deforestation, drought, and mass extinctions.
We need to start treating this crisis like a crisis.
We are on the verge of the abyss.
Could a change to international law be part of the answer? There's now a push for a new crime, ecocide, to be included in the International Criminal Court.
Making ecocide a serious crime alongside war crimes and genocide could really underpin and strengthen the whole edifice of environmental law.
So what does ecocide actually mean? How would it work? And can it really make any difference? This is The Idea. World leaders or corporate CEOs could stand trial in an international court for destroying the natural world, the same court where people are prosecuted for genocide. And the idea has been around for a while, since the 1970s. During the Vietnam War, the US military destroyed vast areas of jungle and crops by spraying Agent Orange, a toxic chemical.
American officials say it doesn't hurt humans or animals or have any lasting effects on soil and vegetation.
An American botanist used the word ecocide to describe what was going on and said we need a new international agreement to ban it.
And then at different points through the 70s, 80s, and even 90s, there were calls for a new convention to go alongside the Genocide Convention.
And now people are talking about it again.
Cambiamo sistema, non il clima.
What do we want?
Climate action.
When do we want it?
Now.
We're nowhere near the climate targets to limit global warming set out in the Paris Agreement. The way we're going, entire coastal cities will be flooded by 2050 because of rising sea levels. In roughly the last 50 years, wildlife populations have declined by around two-thirds, and our oceans are filling up with plastic.
Unless we acknowledge that we're deeply intertwined with the ecosystems that support us, we are heading towards a cliff edge.
As environmental destruction grows, so has support for this idea of ecocide.
I think it's just started to capture people's imagination because there's this urgency around the climate crisis, the environmental crises that we're facing. So this feels like something tangible.
And now we actually have a legal definition for ecocide. This year, a panel of top criminal and environmental lawyers put their heads together for several months. And this is what they came up with. Unlawful or wanton acts committed with knowledge that there is a substantial likelihood of severe and either widespread or long-term damage to the environment being caused by those acts.
It was important to include wanton in that definition, which really means the reckless disregard for damage that's clearly excessive in relation to the social or economic benefits.
So what might this look like? Some environmentalists, for example, think that the tar sands in Alberta, Canada, described as the world's most destructive oil operation, is a form of ecocide. Others think officials at the Fukushima power plant in Japan, who continue dumping radioactive water into the ocean, might also be committing ecocide.
So if a company dumped toxic waste off the coast of, let's say, a country in Africa, and it caused severe and either widespread or long-term damage, that would be a relatively straightforward case for the prosecution. The key to that case would really be to show that those involved knew of the substantial likelihood of that harm occurring.
So where does it go from here? Well, the idea is that it will be adopted by the International Criminal Court. Right now, the ICC has jurisdiction over four kinds of atrocities. They all relate to human suffering. Ecocide, if accepted, would be added as a fifth, a crime against nature. But it will require two-thirds of the court's member states to accept a change to the Rome Statute, the treaty that underpins the ICC.
So that's at least 82 states, which sounds like an awful lot. But if you put together many of those vulnerable states, each state having a vote, it's not perhaps as unreachable as you might think.
And European countries like Belgium and France are getting behind it.
Il faut faire en sorte d'inscrire ce terme dans le droit international.
So how would it work? Well, the law wouldn't be applied retroactively, so no one would go down for, say, Chernobyl. And there are also the limitations of the court itself. Some major countries aren't even members of the ICC, including the world's top three polluters, China, the US, and India. But that doesn't necessarily mean that individuals from non-member countries would be off the hook.
So let's say, I don't know, a US company is committing ecocide in Venezuela. I'm just inventing this. But they have an operational office in Belgium, and Belgium ratifies this. If their CEO sets foot in Belgium, they can be arrested and tried there. So there is a kind of breadth of possibility there.
And it's that individual accountability that supporters of ecocide say might be a really powerful deterrent.
One of the most effective tools that any society has to change behavior is criminal law. And when that criminal law is international, it has a real chance of changing the behavior of even the worst environmental criminals.
The trouble is, there's a lot of doubt about whether the ICC has the teeth to really enforce ecocide. In its nearly 20-year history, the court has heard 30 cases and judges have handed down 10 convictions. And there are still a lot of questions. Would extracting oil count as ecocide? How do you prove there was prior knowledge of severe harm to nature? And are countries that want to keep growing their economies going to see ecocide as an obstacle?
International criminal law is not a panacea for all the ills on the planet. And ecocide can't change everything by itself.
It's not a silver bullet. It's also not going to change the fact that our current system is premised on environmental destruction. So if we don't have this broader systemic change, we will continue to destroy the planet. We'll just also occasionally put someone on trial.
No one's really saying ecocide is the whole answer. But its supporters believe it can be one part of the global fight against environmental destruction. And its power isn't necessarily about putting people in prison. It's about turning up the pressure. If there is another story or a topic you want to get your head around, let us know. Get in touch with us on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook. And make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can't miss our next episode.